Arun Thukral, Managing Director and CEO of Axis Security, joins us now with his take on where markets are headed and where there are pockets of value in this market. Arun, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Is there money to be made in Reliance AMC?
Good morning, Nikunj. You are talking about Reliance AMC, which is just listed. I think over a longer period, and the listing gains. Yeah, sure. Because listing gains have already been made. Now, if you look at the kind of people investing in stock market through mutual fund routes, if you are saying that last year there were 65 lakh SIPs and now there are 1.5 crore SIPs. So the kind of flows the retail investor is now putting in the markets, and I think first time this year we have seen the independence from the FII flows. If you look at this year Independence Day, I think that is the orbit shift, because whatever FIIs were selling, DIs were buying. And I think this year, if after July, at the July end, DI was around 7 billion of inflows and FI was around 9 billion. After that, they started selling the FII and that came to around 5.5. Whereas DI put another 7 billion. So that this kind of money we have never seen in the last few years. And if that is going to continue, if the Indian retail investor is going to put money, if the 3-4% people who are investing in equity is going to double, I think then AMCs are going to definitely be the flavor of the market, and this is the first listing. Going ahead, there will be more listing, and there's more financialization after demonetization. If there are people who are keeping sometime money at home, even for genuine purposes, that money they have to put in the bank because of demonetization. Now that money has to flow somewhere, and that's going into mutual funds. So that's what we have seen the trend. So I am more or less certain, and because the kind of retail investor we are meeting, they are too eager to put money in the market. So on every small correction, they generally come and ask whether they can put more money. They are not afraid. I think that is the change we have seen in the last few years. And this particular, so what they say that every time you say no, this time it is different. But I can say it for conviction that actually this time it is different, because the kind of, let's say, ranking jump we got 30 places, that was not happening in earlier years. Earlier it was maybe one, last year I think we jumped one place. So there are certain work is going on, whether you look at reforms over the last 3 years, starting from financial inclusion with the Jan Dhan account, then financialization of assets through demonetization, then the GST, the reform of the decade, the flow of money from informal to formal, which we have seen today, a brand play if you look at Titan's result today. So I think these things have never happened. These are the reforms of the decade. And last but not the least, the bank recapitalization, because of ailing banking sector, that also is going to do well, and maybe that may help in reviving corporate earning and reviving the private capex. So we at Axis Securities are very bullish.
It's a great time.
From medium to long term.
No, I completely agree with you. It's a great time for the markets, and that's getting reflected in the way the market has moved. In fact, we are now talking 11,000. At least soon enough, we'll be talking 11,000 on the index. You're saying SBI, Punjab National Bank, Bank of Baroda look attractive after the whole PSU bank recap program. So SBI and BOB, I understand, because they're part of portfolios. Are you saying that even after the run at 200 odd, PNB is a compelling buy? And which among the smaller PSU banks do you find favor in? Because that's where the problem has been more stark. And if one of the two of them can resolve their issues, then the comeback can be very strong.
So these are the three banks which we are bullish, and PNB, because in the entire north, PNB is very strong. And going ahead, there will be going to have some consolidation. So there will be very few banks, maybe 5-6 banks. So that's why I think PNB also is in a sweet spot. And on the smaller size bank, as of now, we are not advising any smaller bank. And along with that, obviously, the private bank continues to be there because of the retail focus, because of the technology, because of the capacity or capability to reward the staff or motivation. So some of the private bank also will do well.
Arun, I'd like to, go back to this entire argument of private banks versus PSU banks. because of bank recapitalization, suddenly PSU banks have made a comeback. Do you think the rally in PSU banks is real, it's here to stay, or that's more like a cyclical cyclical flush, and 15-20% and some of these banks, the gains will fade away?
So as I said, that there are few bigger PSU bank who will continue to do well because of their reach, because of their focus in the rural areas and the agriculture focus. So these 3-4 banks will continue to do well, and private bank will obviously continue to march ahead because of the focus on technology, because of the focus on retail. Now the third segment which will get affected is NBFC. Now NBFC, some of the NBFCs are highly valued, and maybe there may be some correction. But again, the debate continues whether the PSU bank will be nimble enough to get into the smaller pockets and the smaller customer, the way NBFCs, the kind of technology they have. So I think we have to wait and see what kind of focus now, whether the culture at PSU bank changes. So there will be some kind of a tussle between NBFCs and PSU bank for the same pie, and private bank will continue to merge because of there are so many other things which PSU bank have to catch up. As I said, one important thing is to reward the staff. In a NBFC or maybe in a private sector bank, you can retain the best talent, and maybe there are incentives to work more, or maybe the fee-based business grows faster. But I think we should not underestimate PSU bank. So there may be culture change, there may be incentives. The government may look at, I'm not sure whether they look at the ESOP for the staff. So if these kind of things happen, I think then there will be an interesting play ahead. Because banks are the barometer of economy, and there is a place. So if you look at the blue ocean strategy, so everybody will find place, because there is a huge, the country is growing. If there are 130 crore Indians, and if the per capita is growing, and we are reaching an inflection point.
Oh, absolutely, Arun. The other talking point today has been that crude has given a breakout after being in that range of 55 to 60 for a while now. What, according to you, could be the implications of crude now above that $60 per barrel mark? How is it that investors should approach the crude sensitives? That's your OMCs as well as aviation as a pack.
So crude, I think the way we look at crude, I think there has to be a cap around 60 because of the shale gas factor. And obviously when we talk about crude and we look at few years back, we were talking about 130 and 140. So I think from that level, we have to come down to, let's say, 55 to 60. So in my mind, there is not going to be much worry, because right now there are production cuts from OPEC and other countries. So if it inches ahead, there will be supply, and the shale gas will be an important factor. So we are not unduly worried about, and obviously the aviation stocks may correct a little bit, and there may be some, the market may be jittery a little bit. But I don't think it's going to be a permanent thing. This may be a temporary blip, and it should settle down.
Yeah, we hope so. Arun, thanks very much for taking out the time to speak with us this morning. Really appreciate your views and your insights. Thanks for making sense of the markets. Okay, we'll take a break. On that note, things are well with the markets. 10,438 sideways. Consolidation continues to be the word on the street this Monday morning. When we come back, get you some more top stories that we are taking stock of right here within an hour and a half into trade.